Dear students, so in the last few classes we have seen something about the diseases because of the microbes. Okay, the microbes involved in diseases and how they are going to cause the infection and how the particular infection developed into diseases and what are all the microbes which can cause the particular diseases, and we have seen so many types of different types of pathogens involved in the particular disease causing agents. Okay, but we are going to see some other perspective of the particular microbes today. That is what the human welfare, the role of microbes in the human welfare. So we are going to discuss something about the beneficial roles of the particular microbes towards the human society. And as I told you in the previous chapters, the microbes, okay, they are the rulers of the world. Actual rulers of the world are microbes. They are present everywhere in the world. Okay, they are omnipresent. They are present in water, soil, air, space, radioactive material, even hot springs, cold conditions. Okay, whatever may be the environmental status, and you can find out some kind of microorganisms. They are unique for the particular environment and they can live at any place in the world, even in the space, as I told you. Okay, so as I told you, the microbes are present everywhere. And here we are going to see something about how the particular microbes, they are going to be beneficial to the human society. That is what we are going to discuss in the particular chapter, the microbes in the human welfare. So we are going to see some sections over here, how the microbes are involved in the making of food products, and how we are going to use them to make the beverages, the alcoholic beverages. And then we are going to discuss something about how we can form some chemicals and bioactive materials from the particular microbes. And then we are going to discuss something about how can we use the microbes to treat the sewage. And then we are going to discuss something about how can we use the microbes as the biocontrolling agents or the biopesticides or bioinsecticide agents by using the particular the microbes. Okay, so we are going to start with the microbes in household products. Okay, especially the food and food related products. Okay, we are going to start with the example, the curd, the making of the curd. So as we all know, curd is we are going to make the particular curd from milk. Okay, so milk is made up of sugar plus some kind of proteins. Okay, so the proteins are called casein protein over here. And normally the raw milk contains some bacteria. They are not much harmful to the human body. Okay, we can call them as commensals or the normal flora. Those normal flora, they can utilize the milk as a normal nutrient source, and they can utilize the particular sugar, and they will form or they are going to digest the particular, partially they are going to digest the sugars and the proteins in the milk, and they are going to form some network like structure. Okay, the partial digestion leads to some network like structure. That is what we are called the making of the curd, the curdling of the particular milk. Okay, and that will be done by, as I told you, the normal flora present in the particular milk, the lactic acid bacteria. Okay, so there are so many types of lactic acid bacteria present in the particular milk, lactococcus, lactobacillus, and there are so many species of lactococcus and lactobacillus available in the milk based on a species, based on a milk type, and based on a handling condition. The species may be vary, but whatever may be the bacteria over here, the role of the particular lactic bacteria, they are going to make the curd out of the particular milk. They are going to partially digest the milk. They are going to form the network like structure, and that will trap the particular milk proteins, and that will lead to the formation of the curd. And apart from the conversion or transformation from milk to curd, that will transform the nutrient value of the particular milk too. Okay, so over here, compared to milk, the nutrient value of the curd is more than the particular milk, because the addition of the particular bacterial inoculum into the milk will add up some more nutrients because of the particular the digestion or the fermentation by the particular bacteria. Okay, so over here it will add up some vitamins also while it is making or converting the particular milk into curd. Fine. And the second example over here, we are going to see something, the bacteria, sorry, something, the microbe, we are going to use it in the bakery industry. So in the baking industry, they are going to use you might have seen some pellet like structure, the green or light green like pellets in your home kitchen. Okay, so those pellets are nothing but yeast. Yeast, their scientific name is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Okay, so this is the name of the particular yeast or baker's yeast. Okay, so the role of baker's yeast over here, it is gonna make the dough, the flour. Okay, so over here it is gonna partially ferment the particular flour and the particular dough, and it is gonna release carbon dioxide, and the release of carbon dioxide by means of fermentation by the particular microbe will increase the volume of the particular dough, and that is the initial or primary stage in the making of the particular bakery products. Okay, so we can call this yeast primarily as baker's yeast. Okay, the name of the baker's yeast over here, as I told you, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, and they are being involved in the making of the bakery products. Fine. Like that, there are so many microbial products or fermentation by means of microbes. Okay. For example, another term, the toddy. Toddy is a sap from palm. Okay, it is being fermented by microbes. Toddy is a product name. Okay, and another thing, the major product from the microbial industry, the cheese. Okay, cheese is another product from the dairy industry. And over here, the fermentation is by means of variety of microbes, based on a variety of microbe, based on a type of species. The cheese character, the color, the flavor, the taste, and the consistency may be vary. For example, there are two types of cheese given for you in your book. Swiss cheese. Okay, Swiss cheese is being fermented by the bacterium Propionibacterium charmani. Okay, and over here, the Swiss cheese, you can see large size of holes over on the surface of the particular Swiss cheese. The holes are nothing but the release of the huge amount of carbon dioxide released by the metabolic activities of the particular bacterium growing in the particular cheese. And another type of cheese over here given for you, the Roquefort cheese. Roquefort cheese is nothing but the normal cheese, and the surface is being grown by the fungi. Okay, that fungi gonna give some specific flavor to the particular type of cheese, and that kind of cheese is called a Roquefort cheese. Okay, and these are all the things you should know. You should remember something about the household products from the microbes. Okay, what are all we have seen over here? We have discussed something about the making of curd by means of the lactic acid bacteria, and they are going to enhance the flavor, and they are going to add up some more nutrient value to the particular milk. As I told you, curd, they are having better nutrient value compared to the milk. And in the baking industry, the using of the Saccharomyces cerevisiae and the toddy. Then we have seen something about the cheese, and now we are going to move to the next heading over here, the microbes in industrial products. Okay, so how in the industrial scale the microbes is being used. So whenever we are talking about the industrial scale by using microbes, okay, you should remember the term fermenters. There are so many terms we are going to use for fermenters, the bioreactors. Okay, so fermenters are the huge volume vessel. Okay, so there are fermenters available. The volume, the capacity may be around some 1 liter capacity, sorry, 1 lakh liter capacity. That much of huge volume of vessels, we are going to use it as the fermenters. Actually, the fermenters are nothing but the bioreactors. Okay, and within that, we are gonna allow the fermentation by using the microbes, and we are gonna give some raw materials to use it as a sugar source or the nutrient source, and conversion of the raw material into products by means of the particular microbes. That is what called the bioreactors or the fermenter vessel. Okay, so we are gonna do it in a industrial scale. That is why we are calling this as industrial microbiology. Or we are going to use the particular microbes to produce the industrial scale or industrial level or huge level of or amount of products from the particular industry. And we are going to see so many types of industrial products over here, and we are going to start with the the form under beverages. So whenever we are talking about the beverages, we are talking about the alcoholic beverages. Okay, there are so many types of alcoholic beverages available in the industry: wine, brandy, whiskey, beer, rum. Okay, so they are all being produced by the microbes by fermenting cereals or fruits. Okay, so based on a type of the particular beverage and based on a flavor, based on a name, they are being produced from cereals or fruits. Okay, by means of specific kind of microbes. As I told you, the baker's yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, one of the major microbe involved over here, the formation of the alcohol or ethanol. Okay, so the alcoholic fermentation is also based on the fermentation by means of the Saccharomyces cerevisiae or the baker's yeast. Okay, as I told you, based on a substrate, the product may get vary. And one more thing, you have to remember over here, based on the process. Okay, based on a process means with or without distillation. This is what you have to remember, something about the making of the alcoholic beverages. Okay, for example, the wine and beer. Okay, wine and beer, there will be no distillation process going to happen over here. They are the direct fermentation product from the particular action of microbes. But the remaining thing, the brandy, whiskey, rum are the distilled products from the particular the fermenters. Okay, and these are all the things you should remember, something about the fermented beverages. The point you have to remember over here, the entire process we are going to perform in the fermenters. The fermenters are the large or huge vessels, and over there we are going to add the raw materials or the nutrient source for the fermentation process, that is for the microbes. And we are going to add the inoculum into the particular fermenter. That particular microbes, they are going to utilize the particular raw material and they are going to produce the products. Over here the products are the alcoholic beverages, and there are so many types of alcoholic beverages we have seen, and the types based on the two things. One thing, based on a substrate, whether you are going to use the cereals or fruits as a substrate, then whether you are going for distillation or without distillation. Okay, based on that, there are so many types of alcoholic beverages available on the market. Fine. The next product, the industrial product, we are going to see something about the antibiotics. Okay, so what do you mean by antibiotics? So antibiotics refers to, anti refers to the negative prefix. Okay, anti plus bio, anti against bio life. Okay, antibiotics refers to against life. This is what the exact meaning for the particular term antibiotics. But over here, this is not against human life, this is against some pathogens. Okay, against some pathogens. Okay, in scientific experiments, there is a term called serendipity or accidental discovery, and this is one of the thing, this is being accidentally being discovered by Alexander Fleming. Okay, so what he did, he was working with a bacterium called Staphylococcus aureus. Okay, and accidentally he has found that some bacterium or some plates, petri plates with medium which contains his bacterium, they could not grow around some new colonies. Okay, and he has found that there are some substances produced by those new colonies, and those substances, they are going to kill the particular bacterium, his own bacterium. Okay, and he has found out that particular substance is called antibiotic. He has named it as antibiotics. Okay, and later the studies from Chain and Florey. Okay, Chain and Florey, they have got the Nobel Prize for the particular antibiotic works. Okay, so after Alexander Fleming, the works from Chain and Florey, and they have commercially used the particular antibiotics, and they have with the help of chain and fluorine, the antibiotics have been used in the World War II. Okay, for the injured soldiers, it is being used. Okay, and this is what the history you have to remember something about the antibiotics. But the point you have to remember over here, antibiotics, one of the after vaccines, antibiotics are the one of the huge volume of products produced from the microbial industry. Okay, so without microbes, we cannot imagine the word antibiotics. With antibiotics, we can eliminate so many different kinds of diseases caused by so many pathogens. Okay, so these are all the points you have to remember something about antibiotics. Apart from, so Alexander Fleming has discovered streptomycin. So after that, today we have some thousands of hundreds of antibiotics available in the market. There are some direct antibiotics and there are some derivative antibiotics. Okay, there are some thousands of antibiotics available: canamycin, chloramphenicol, okay, tetracycline. There are so many types of antibiotics available in the market. Almost all are basically derived from microbes. After that, it is being synthetically modified, or it is being derived from the natural antibiotics. Okay, so we have to thank only the microbial world for the antibiotics. Without antibiotic, we cannot be alive as we are today. Fine. And the next set of industrial products we are going to see over here, the chemicals, enzymes and bioactive products from the particular, or bioactive molecules from the particular microbial industry. So as I told you, the chemicals, there are some organic acids, so lactic acid, acetic acid, citric acid, butyric acid. Okay, these are all the chemicals it is being produced by the microbes in a huge volume. Okay, so as I told you, production of the particular organic acid, normally these organic acids are the byproducts or the metabolic products of the particular specific kind of the microbe. Okay, for example, over here the citric acid is being produced by the microbe called Aspergillus niger, and acetic acid is being produced by Acetobacter aceti, and the butyric acid is being produced by Clostridium butylaticum, and lactic acid, as I told you, lactic acid is produced by so many types of lactobacillus and lactococcus bacteria. Okay, and these are all called organic acids, or one of the major group of the industrial products it is being produced by the microbes. Okay, so Aspergillus niger is a fungi, Acetobacter, Clostridium, lactobacillus are belongs to bacteria, and these microbes, they can produce the particular group of organic acids. As I told you, the process is the outline process is same. You are gonna start with the fermenter, and over there you are gonna transfer the nutrients required for the particular microbes, and those microbes, they are gonna ferment the particular raw material. They are gonna utilize or metabolize the particular raw material, and after that the metabolic products are the organic acid, and then we are gonna purify the organic acids or the chemicals from the particular medium. And we are going to see these details or the steps involved in the formation of the microbial industrial products in the next chapter. But the point you have to remember over here, these are all the acids or organic acids produced by, these are all the microbes. This is what you have to remember something about the chemicals. And then come back to the enzymes. There are so many different types of enzymes also it is being produced by the microbial industry. You cannot number the particular number of enzymes. There are huge volume and different types of enzymes are being produced by the particular microbial industry. For example, while you are using the detergent powder, you might have seen some the colored granules or balls in the particular detergent powder. They are all nothing but the enzyme molecules, and all enzyme molecules are being produced by the particular microbial industry. For example, there are some color molecules, they may be lipases. Okay, so lipases are one of the major enzymes involved in the particular the laundry products. Okay, the lipases, they are gonna use to isolate, or they are gonna use to wash out the particular the oily products from the particular the laundry materials. Okay, so lipases are the one of the major enzymes which is being produced by the microbial industry. Other examples, the pectinases and proteases. Okay, So you might have seen the juices, the bottled juices, and while you are compared to the fresh juices you are preparing in your home, the bottled juices are clearer than the home juices. So the reason behind that, it is being cleared, cleared by clearing agents. Okay, so clearing agents are nothing but they are being digested by, or their protein content or the large protein junks is being digested by some enzymes, and that is what called pectinases and proteases. All the fruit juice industry, they are being based on the particular pectinases and proteases, and those two enzymes also being produced by the microbial industry. And another example given for you in your book, the streptokinase. Streptokinase is an enzyme is being produced by the bacterium streptococcus. Okay, so streptococcus or streptokinase over here, the kinase over here, they are being used as the clot busters. Okay, so why we are calling these enzymes as clot busters? So the term contains the answer. Clot busters refers to, it can bust the blood clots. Okay, so the patients with some blood clots is being treated with the particular streptokinase enzyme, and it can prevent the particular the clotting by the particular in the movement of the blood in the particular blood vessels. Okay, so that is the application of the streptokinase. As I told you, streptokinase is being produced by the bacteria streptococcus. Fine. And another molecule, as I told you, there are some so many types of bioactive molecules is also being produced by the microbes. And one example given for you over here, the cyclosporine A. Cyclosporine A is one of the major bioactive molecule is being produced by a type of fungi called Trichomonas polysporum. Okay, the polysporum fungi, and the application of the particular cyclosporine A over here, as I told you, it is a immunosuppressive agent. What do you mean by immunosuppressive agent? For example, a person is being transplanted. Transplanted means you're gonna transfer an organ from one person to the another person or next person. So what will happen? The organ rejection may be happen. What is the reason behind the organ rejection? As I told you in the previous chapters, because of the immune system of the recipient. Okay, the recipient immune system will accept, it won't accept the particular foreign organ. It will recognize that object as foreign object, and that will try to eliminate, or that will try to eject the particular organ from the human body. Okay, that is what called the rejection of the transplanted organ. Okay, so in those kind of patients, the treatment will normally like this, immunosuppressive treatment. Okay, so in those patients, they'll give some, they will administered with some immunosuppressive agents that will suppress most of the actions of the particular immune system. Okay, and cyclosporine A is one of the major immunosuppressive agent, and that will be used to treat the particular the transplanted patients. Okay, and these are all the details you should remember something about the microbial products, the industrial products. And now we are going to move to the next section, that is, as I told you, the microbes. How can we use the microbes to treat the sewage plants? Okay, and then we are going to see something about how can we use the microbes to control the agents, that is the bio insecticide and the bio pesticide. That is what we are going to see now.